Tony's replacement has some ground to cover with the staff also, but doesn't quite seem up to the effort in Shortland Street.
So who do I get to fill in for you?
You bring her the gig, it's what she wants.
Have you been given the nod already? Nursing manager.
No, but I'm happy to step into the breach.
The job's yours, and you know it.
Brenda Holloway, this is James Scott.
Please, call me Scotty.
I've just appointed Scotty interim nursing manager. So, here's the plan. Scotty is on loan from Central until I appoint a permanent nursing manager. He's very experienced, comes highly recommended. As well as running the ship, he will also be assessing you guys and any other senior nurses putting their hands up for the job. Then he'll make his recommendations to me.
Great, so I'm still in the running then.
Don't feel pressured though, just carry on as normal. And I will be advertising the position externally. Would you care to say a few words?
I'm playing catch-up right now, but obviously I expect the full cooperation of the nursing staff. I should say straight off that I tend to be pretty upfront, and I like to be treated the same way. But I'm sure that's standard policy here.
Oh yeah, we're all about team around here.
That's all.
Any questions? So, spread the word and let's try to make this a smooth transition. Thanks for stepping in at such short notice, mate. How can we start you off?
The first thing I need is a handover with Tony.
Unfortunately, she has taken annual leave as of today.
Phone call will do.
Yeah, I'd really prefer you to come into this from a fresh perspective. It's the main reason I brought you in. You're above the politics.
What politics might that be?
The usual stuff. Yeah, nothing you can't handle.
I get this text from Alice. When you see Jay, just say yes.
Short version, I'm single, I'm brown, and I'm homeless.
Ah, yeah, I heard the rumour. I'm really sorry.
Thanks, but it's been coming for a while. But I heard a rumour that you've got a spare room available.
Oh, I sure have.
And I know that recently separated doesn't look good on my CV. However, I'm steadily employed.
Hey,
I'm
don't have to give me the hard sell. We want a friend to move in, not some random. It's yours.
TK, that is such a load off my mind. Thank you.
So when do you want to move your stuff?
Well, would tonight be pushing it?
Things at home pretty tense, huh?
Yeah, we're barely talking.
It must be hard for you. And Maya?
Don't worry about her. She's well and truly moved on.
I thought Brenda was going to faint.
Well, I thought she was going to get the job. Or perhaps you, Maya.
Well, I can see why you did it. Gives everyone time to really step up.
And suck up.
Well, it is nice to see you being so positive. I know things must be rocky with Jay.
Good to have something else to focus on.
You really want this job, eh?
And the money that comes with it.
Shopping power, yeah!
No, I told you. All my money's going towards the baby-making business. That's all I care about.
Hey, what are we doing standing around gossiping at work? We've got dinner to make. Why did you?
I can't wait. I'm so over today.
You know how I said I'd be the one to tell her?
No way. That's your job. Bloodies! Yay!
Hey, I've got a big favour, but are you going to be around tonight? Because I really need a moving buddy.
Of course!
Alice, strong like ox!
Have you finished your shift?
Almost.
You just look like you have, that's all.
Hey,
I think you guys are pretty young to be our boss, don't you think?
Experience is the only thing that counts.
Still, I never thought I'd be a contender. But now, who knows?
Oh, absolutely. Chris obviously highly values your work.
What is that about? Tony quit. Everyone's gunning for a job.
Whoa, even Maya?
Yes, even she who shall not be named from now on. But Big Brenda, she wants it bad. And now she's got to grease up the new guy. His name's Scotty, which sounds like a small furry dog, but he's actually mildly hot.
Whoa, lucky you.
Oh, no, not my type. Seriously, he talked like an uptight relief teacher.
Well, then Brenda should get along with him well, then.
We'll see.
Do you need to see me?
Oh, I've just left some files and things on your desk. Don't want to clutter.
No, they're not bothering me. I thought this was Tony's base, though.
Well, I took over some of her responsibilities when she resigned, so this was my temporary home.
I see. Anything I need to keep my eye on?
Your stress levels. You said you wanted us to be up front. Did you mean it?
Absolutely.
Okay. Well, the rosters are a mess. The study hours have been neglected. The newbie's orientation is inadequate, bordering on dangerous. Do you get the picture?
And all this is due to Tony's management?
We all have our own little systems, don't we?
And your little systems would be different?
And stress-free.
Right. Thanks for the heads up.
Anytime.
What is that?
Entrees.
Mark, cheese and dip is not an entree. You said you were going to do a proper one.
Firstly, it's an expensive dip. And secondly, Maya will be fine.
I think I've changed my mind. We can't do this to her, not in the middle of a marriage breakup.
Do you mean we don't tell her now?
I mean, maybe you should still be the donor.
We've been over this.
I know, but she's going to hate me and you.
Not for long. Tanya, we made a decision. We need to stick to it. It'll all be over soon.
Okay. I'm sorry for freaking out.
It's okay. Go get changed.
Oh, can you handle the pan?
I'm your pan handler.
Okay.
I don't see why he got an outsider to babysit. And from Central, of all places.
It does seem strange.
It's a kick in the teeth is what it is. I could easily have done that job while they're taking applications, but no.
Mm.
And you should see the guy. I should be taking orders from him. I should be packing him a play lunch.
Maya told me that he was young.
Oh. Sorry, Yvonne. I'm ranting. Maya would have been a perfectly good choice too.
Oh, don't be silly. You're the one with all the experience.
You know, I must admit his CV is pretty hot. And he does seem to have his head screwed on. We'd probably get on pretty well if I didn't want to thump him every time I see him.
That works in your favour, doesn't it?
What, physical violence?
If his head is screwed on, he'll see that you are the best candidate and tell Chris.
So it's a temporary setback, you reckon?
Won't take him long to see who does all the work around here.